We have seen this battle seesaw back and forth. We saw it at 5 seconds the last time we checked the interval. Now it's 4.4. It has opened. It has closed. Really, it puts all the pressure, like you said, David, on this man, Ryan Hughes. He has to just unload because at the moment, Lampson, especially in that section, and you can really see the difference now, can't you, with the tips that Jeremy has given Lampson.
Right. Well, Ryan Hughes trying to do the same thing that Lampson's doing up that hill, but you know what? I got to think that Lampson's bike is a little bit faster than Ryan Hughes's, and that makes a huge difference in an uphill section and jumps, which requires mostly just horsepower. So it's a big advantage for Steve Lampson.
Now, of course, speaking of horsepower, there's going to be a big jump in horsepower next year for Ryan Hughes. He has signed a contract with Kawasaki. He'll be on the 250, and he's actually more comfortable on the 250, isn't he, David?
Well, I think so. He seems to, making up for a little bit of lack of horsepower in the 125. I mean, the bike is very fast. He gets good starts, but it's just not quite fast enough, and that teeny little bit of difference makes a lot of difference in the 125 class. So he rides a little smoother on the 250s. He's got the horsepower, and now in the Trophy to Nations, he's riding a 500, and I think he's going to ride even better.
And you saw there briefly Jeff Stanton. You can see he had his wrist tape there. We mentioned him earlier. He's had all kinds of surgeries, something like 13 pins in that particular hand. He was hit by an automobile that came off the highway. He was just at a stop on a motorcycle, and thankfully he's here today and cheering on his rider, Steve Lampson. Now, of course, Ryan Hughes, Wyatt Seals and his camp will be cheering him on, and they're hoping he can close this gap on Lampson.
Well, this is one of those motos where you can see how important the start is. If Ryan Hughes had gotten the whole shot and Lampson was third or fourth, this whole thing could be going the other way. So the start, as always, proves to be probably the deciding factor of a moto, and in this case, maybe the title.
A pretty good run today for number 101, Mikel Pichon. Currently runs in fourth place. He's had a good run, but really today, in the light of the championship, I'm sure a lot of people are not really focusing on him, but he hasn't really got his momentum on the outdoors like you thought he might.
Right, and it's difficult in a day like today when you got two riders, the fastest riders of the season, really, that are battling for the championship. And if you were to get up there and mix it up with him, you just sort of feel out of play. So it's tough for these riders. And it looks like Pichon will be going back to Europe next year to contest the world championships. And a fine ride over here in the 125 Supercross. Not the same kind of success in the outdoors, but still a very promising rider, young.
It'll be a shame to lose him on the Supercross. He was exciting to watch, but he's returning, as you said, to Europe. Damon Huffman currently runs in fifth place, so he has picked up a spot. Not enough, certainly, to help him in the championship, but he's hoping to hang on to third, like we spoke. That's a big improvement from his seventh place finish in the championship, that is, last year.
Well, it's about all he can really do. Just go out and try to ride his best. I mean, this day, really, for a few guys, Mike Brown, and now, as it appears, after the first moto for Damon Huffman, just get through the moto, it's more or less just a workout. It's really not going to accomplish much. Just keep it on two wheels, lock down third in the championship, and go home, wait till next year.
Damon Huffman, of course, we saw him in moto number one get caught by the gate. That's really where he struggled this year, is on the starts. If he can cure that, he certainly could go to the front here next year. A guy who certainly never struggled on the gate is Steve Lampson. He's got great starts all year.
Well, and it's really paying off for him today, as we just pointed out. The start perhaps is the deciding factor of the championship today, and I bet you he's glad he got it today at the second moto.
The Honda Field Summary shows him on top. Hughes, Brown, Pichon, and Huffman round out the top five. But don't forget, there's only about 4 seconds that decide the championship. Still has things going his way. You saw briefly there Jeff Stanton cheering him on, but now he does have to work through some lap riders. That can be scary, David.
Well, now you can see it's the white flag, and as it's one lap to go, those lap riders can be a real problem for Steve Lampson, because anytime you're the leader of the race, a lot of times they're not aware that the leaders are catching him, and by the time second place comes through, they're already getting out of the way. That could play into the favor of Ryan Hughes, and there's only about 4 seconds separating these two.
In moto number one, we saw a great battle at the end on the final lap. Remember, it takes over 3 minutes to get a 125 around this course. There's plenty of racing left, but that time it was Lampson chasing Ryan Hughes, but now it's the other way around. Can 4 seconds be cut by Ryan Hughes? If anybody can do it, it'll be Ryan Hughes, and boy, he'll be exciting to watch on this last lap.
I'm sure he will, and as I watch Steve Lampson right here, I bet you he's just waiting to explode with excitement, but he can't do it yet because you can see right there, 4 seconds separates him from Ryan Hughes. And as long as Hughes is that close, if there's any mistake by Lamson, he's going to lose the title. So it's all on the line here with about a half a lap to go.
Not only is it 4 seconds, but it's less than it was. It's 4.1. We saw it at 4.4. It doesn't sound like much, but psychologically, he is catching. The flaggers are getting out there. Oh, look who that was. 7:08, Ryan Huffman. He's tangled with him before. He'll have to be sure he clears him. He doesn't want to get in the middle of this championship battle, and we'll watch him carefully as he works his way through. We saw Ryan Huffman, I believe, look over his shoulder. He knows that Lamson is there. Lamson's being somewhat cautious, and he's done it. So he's worked his way past a couple guys. Now, unfortunately, Hughes will have to do the same thing.
That's right. And Hughes looks like he's a little bit too far back to put any kind of pressure on Steve Lamson. At this point, with less than a half a lap to go, I think Lamson is finally starting to feel like this title may be his. All he's got to do is keep it on two wheels, and I think he's going to win this title.
Now, of course, this will be crushing for Ryan Hughes. He's had a great year this year, but he wanted so badly to win the championship and dedicate it to his father, who helped him in his early part of his career, passed away last year, never had an opportunity to see Ryan Hughes win. And now, of course, since that time, he's put it all together, wanted to dedicate this season to his father. But there'll be other opportunities.
I'm sure there will. And as you saw Lamson come out of that left-hander back there, he glanced over at the racetrack coming into the corner to the side, and you can see that he's still got a pretty comfortable lead over Hughes. That's going to help him relax. I can already sort of see it. It looks like he's riding more relaxed, and he's still going fast, but it's all coming easier, and I think you can start to smell that checkered flag.
Steve Lamson getting ever closer to the title in 1995 on these 125 machines. Remember, he was 61 points behind after the third round this year. No one thought he had any opportunity, but hang on, here comes Ryan Hughes. We can see him in the picture. It looks like he's taking advantage of Lamson, taking it a little easy. However, we see Lamson look over his shoulder. He knows Hughes is coming.
He knows he's coming, but it's the nerves. The nerves of knowing that somebody has caught you that quick. And if you make any bobble at all, he's going to be right on you, possibly close enough to stuff you in the final corner.
Listen to the fans. The Honda mechanics are out trying to encourage Steve Lamson. There's only yards to go. There it is, the checkered flag. Our champion for 1995, Steve Lamson, has done it. And Ryan Hughes makes his way. He's got a problem. Ryan Hughes has got a problem with the bike. He's trying to push it to the line. We're looking back to see. That's a lapper. So is that. He's going to try and get it to the line to try and save his second place. Oh, crushing for Ryan Hughes. It's uphill to the finish line. We're looking to see.
There's no chain on that motorcycle. He has broken a chain. Look at how steep that uphill is. I don't think this is going to matter for the overall title. He might lose some spots in this moto. He's got to push this motorcycle all the way up this hill. And if there's one guy out there that can do it, it's Ryan Hughes. He's tough.
We're looking to see if anyone, I believe Mike Brown, has not crossed the finish line yet. We're watching them go by. So far, no one for position. They can't help him. His mechanics are there. Oh, they want, there goes Mike Brown. Oh, he's lost one spot.
I've never seen anything like this, especially on the final lap of a moto. He's got to push this bike. He must be completely exhausted. The emotions of having just lost the title, and then for his chain to come off just to make things even tougher. What a disappointing day for Ryan Hughes. You can see him right there. Wyatt Seals catching up with him to take his goggles off. Very disappointed.
Moto2 shows that Ryan Hughes did hang on to third place. Mikel Pichon slotted it in fourth, and in fifth, of course, was Damon Huffman. But the day belongs to Steve Lamson. He receives the number one plate from AMA's Duke Finch. Unbelievable run for him. 61 points down early in the season, and that total of 467 surpasses Doug Henry's 1994 championship run. Of course, a tough, tough day for Ryan Hughes. But look at this. He never gives up. Pushed it up. Finished third today. Second in the championship. A great run for him. He was third last year. He also surpassed his points total from